I'm Dr. Lindsay Lally. I'm a rheumatologist at the Hospital for Special Surgery. Today we're going to be talking about osteoarthritis. Osteoarthritis is one of the most common causes of chronic joint conditions affecting over 27 million Americans. Osteoarthritis most commonly occurs in the knees, hips, spine, neck, small joints of the fingers, the base of the thumb, and the big toe. What happens to a joint during osteoarthritis? The cartilage in a joint becomes stiff and loses its elasticity, which can cause damage over time. As the cartilage deteriorates, tendons and ligaments stretch, causing pain. If the condition worsens, the bones could rub against each other. There are several factors that increase a person's chances of developing osteoarthritis. As you get older, your joints tend to get worn down. Most types of arthritis are more common in women, except for gout. Obesity increases the risk for osteoarthritis of the knee, hip, and spine. Excessive weight can put stress on joints, which can lead to cartilage damage. For every pound of excess weight, you add 4 pounds of pressure on the knees. Maintaining ideal weight or losing excess weight may help prevent osteoarthritis of these areas or decrease the rate of progression once OA is established. Injuries contribute to the development of osteoarthritis. For example, athletes who have had knee-related injuries may be at higher risk of developing osteoarthritis of the knee. People who have had a broken bone near a joint are prone to develop osteoarthritis in that joint. Overuse of certain joints increases the risk of developing osteoarthritis. For example, people in jobs requiring repeated bending of the knee are at increased risk for developing osteoarthritis of the knee. People with rheumatoid arthritis, the second most common type of arthritis, are more likely to develop osteoarthritis. Patients often wonder when they should be evaluated by a doctor for their joint symptoms. Pain, swelling, or stiffness in one or more joints, joints that are red or warm to the touch, tenderness or stiffness of the joints, difficulty moving a joint or doing daily activities. It is also important for you to arrive at your doctor's appointment with a list of prepared questions and a paper for you to write down notes during your visit. If you're having a joint symptom that's causing a concern, seeing a primary care physician is a good place to start. The following are some points to think of in preparation for your doctor's visit. Functional status. How is your arthritis impacting your daily life? Pain level. Try to think of 1 to 2 descriptive words. What triggers your pain? What makes it better? Overall well-being. How is your arthritis affecting your personal relationships? How well are you managing the medications that you're taking? Always arrive with a list of written questions for your doctor.